Hello, I am TD Stoneheart, and today I will play through Castlevania Scenery Hacks by TD Stoneheart myself. This ROM hack was made very long ago, maybe 6 or 7 years or so, and I haven't touched it ever since. And so now when I played this ROM hack again, it was like a brand new experience. Well, there is a shortcut, but I won't go that way to demonstrate the game. I prefer that way. I'm not sure, but as far as I can see, at that time I tend to create ROM hacks to be much easier than the original. Not so challenging for the first stages. But until one stage in the mid game, I could see a really great challenge for everyone who plays it, and we'll see. Well, I'm not sure why, but the music in this ROM hack is quite garbled. So I don't want to turn up the volume for in-game sounds. Rather, I would like to use commentary instead. So now we'll get to the first boss of this game. Oh. Find a good place to drop the holy water. Yeah, like that. Nice. Okay, so let's see that the first stage is something like a spring stage, and this one is, well, as far as I could remember, this is a summer stage, and everything got grayscale because of the rain, because of the thunderstorms, something like that. And you see the windows to the outside, it was so dull because of the heavy rains making things quite dull to see. And well, you see a shortcut here. I would go that way. I won't go that way, but instead I will go the longest way around to demonstrate the game. Yeah, this is a shortcut, but I won't go that way. Instead I want to still use that old butt go trick to go up by exploiting the Marissa heads. Well, this stage looks a little bit dull. Oh. So unforgiving. Well, I could skip the Medusa heads. And now we will go to the boss. Well, with the Hollywood, with at least two some, I could defeat it quite easily. So the first walk is a spring stage. The block that we've gone through shortly is the summer stage. So it's quite logical for this to be the autumn stage. Well, seasons change so quickly in this game. The stage layout doesn't seem to change much in these first stages. But fear not, we will get to real challenges in some more minutes. I haven't played Castlevania for a very long time, so not really good. I've lost so much HP at this point. And if I played the original Castlevania at that point, maybe I have already been dead at this point. So in this stage, we will see branching paths. I will go the more challenging way, I guess. Nice. It is a medicine jar. Things would be easier when there are some artificial platforms, I guess. And off we go to the winter stage, actually the ice caver. I'm not sure if I could go up this platform. I have to be very careful. No. But that's fine. We're still in the second, in the same point. Besides these shortcut platforms, the stage then city has changed. And here is the real challenge. And let's see. No, I would like to go the conventional way. It seems to be safe to go here, but no. So we'll need to go to the higher platforms. And if we are not careful enough, we just fall down to the long hallway below, and we will have to go traverse from the beginning. I want to be really careful here. Ah. Let's try it this way. No. Why is that? Well, why am I dead at this point? I can't understand it. As some trivial chit chat, I would really like to replace the music of this ROM hack to the one created, not really one, but the music created by myself. Currently I am a composer for my own humble Lux music project, and I think some of my music could be used for a game, something like a game soundtrack. But to replace in-game music, I really need to learn assembly or something like that. Some very hardcore programming. Maybe I should stop going the challenging way. And I think this stage is a really fun challenge for Castlevania veterans. Let's be safe here. I will need this one. I will accept to go from the beginning again to get a really good upgrade for the Holy Warrior. No, please. No! Let's be safe. No, I still got damage. No. This seems to be the safest lane to go. let's face the very annoying bosses this game. I'll go the hardcore way. No. Not really a core way. Because I kind of cheated with the holy world. And well, let's go to the next place. The next stage when we have completed the four seasons. Let's go. I see. Now we are in the something like Super Mario World. Maybe. So in this stage, I am presented with fake walls, something like Castlevania 2 Simon's Quest, something like that. Mario and Luigi and the Goombas are all over the place. It seems to be like a castle courtyard with Mario wallpapers.
No!
Oh no! Well, this is the real challenge in the pathway to the Green Ribbon. No! I need to memorize the pit. Got through the fake walls. Seeing Mario and Luigi chasing for the one-up mushroom. A lot of Goombas on the way. Fine, it will be a challenge for me. Oh, no, I don't want to die that soon.
No!
Oh, Actually, it is just the original Castlevania experience. The same challenge from Castlevania's game itself. I guess Grim Reaper is easy to beat with this cross. Yeah, quite easier because it can exterminate many hats along the way, but I still can't get it. So annoying. Ah. Let's put the crosses all the way. No, no, please. No, don't touch me. No! No! Oh, it's so annoying. I haven't touched this game for 6-7 years or so, and I couldn't memorize everything. Face the death again. No. How could they detect my position? No. It is so unfair. Really, really unfair. This placement of the sides. No. No! Finally, I could complete the stage. And what comes next? Let's see. Oh, world, the greatest world. I prefer the cross. Right. Oh. Okay, thanks. A nice way to traverse this stage. Oh! Actually, It is not challenging, but it is my personal fault. And in this stage, we have big vipers all over the place. So it gives an illusion of a space stage. Don't let me go through. Okay, so finally escaped. Have to be careful in this portion of the stage. Well, so lucky. Luckily, I didn't fall. Okay, let's go and meet Dracula. This concept looks like something in the final stage in Super Castlevania 4 or Bloodstained Curse of the Moon. And here we will see a much more challenging final battle arena. Pits are so annoying to me. But maybe experienced players might find this arena interesting and more challenging. No! No! So annoying. I don't know why Dracula always spawns on my position. It is ridiculous. But let's try a safer method. But no, it doesn't seem to be safer, but well, I still die. Well, throughout the game, I think stages 11 and 18 are the best challenges of this game. although other stages were made easier. No. Dracula seems to have a sensor that always try to spawn at my position. It is annoying. Really annoying. No! Oh no! It is so hard. I shouldn't go up the stairs and whip him because it is hard to dodge his fireballs. No. No! Myself 6 or 7 years could not imagine of such kind of challenge. Maybe I'm not sure why I could make such thing, but as far as I could remember, being able to hack around is something like a very marvelous thing to do, especially when the time was in the early 2010s. Quite fun to hang around at that time, to play with it. Maybe in the near future, if I have time, maybe I will add more challenge to this ROM hack, keeping the stage 11 and this stage intact while making other stages harder. No. No! No! So, the war chicken is there, but I wasn't aware of this existence, so I could use it for a little bit more health. No. No. Why does he always spawn at my landing position? Oh, this is unfair. Really unfair. No. Right. Two more hits. Okay, so let's try getting to this upper platform and bombard from above. Nice one. Ah, no, you can't beat me. Get down and just whip and slash. Nice. Oh, finally, I've beaten the ROM hack I've made myself, but in the situation where I haven't played it for a very long time, when I was really busy and I couldn't make any more ROM hacks, and I had to focus on my study. And on some random occasion, I found someone played my ROM hack on YouTube, so I couldn't wait to touch my work again. And well, that's all for the playthrough. Thank you for watching.